All right, guys, so we're gonna do the pairing shift stop today. Oh, I gotta get a light in here for later. All right, I'm gonna peel off these knobs first thing here. All right, guys, so we're gonna do the pairing shift knob. And what am I talking about? All right, guys, we're gonna do the pairing shift stop install. I know I'm like the last guy to make this video, so it's not very exciting, and I don't expect to get any surprises. So first thing I'm going to do is take off my RaceEng Orbiture knob with the Durlin coating and the solid core, and to make it easier to get everything off. And I will temporarily put on my stock knob for like a few tests as I drive around, because this thing takes a little while to get on and off with all the set screws and everything. So I'm just going to screw on the stock one for my test, so when it's all perfectly adjusted, I'll put this Orbiture back on. Rolling the knob. Rolling the knob. Man, that's a heavy knob. Alright, so I got a screwdriver down here, screwdriver here. Take this off, then I'm good to go. All right, now I'm gonna lift up and pull out the boot. Now this thing is a little bit worn because remember I've had a few bezels in here. I've been messing with it. I think the wear is more on the boot than the bezel. The boot is what has the tabs. So when I pull this up like this, it's supposed to pop the whole thing, but sometimes the boot just comes out. So it just takes, oh, look at my dome light again. It just started doing that a second ago as I was talking. All right. Oh yeah, someone said maybe make sure it's seated. I don't think it's going to be that easy, but I'll check. And most people I see when I read this, they just replace the bulb and they're solved. Probably maybe got a bad bulb or something. Anyway, okay, so I pull in the sides. Oh, see the, dang it. You gotta get real deep. Oh my God, it's tight. Oh, there we go. See, some sides come up properly the whole way, and sometimes the boot comes out right there. Yeah. Oh, whew. That is insane. Jeez, I don't know. Yeah, see, the boot has the tabs, and that's what wears out a little. And that's why when I'm pulling up, after I've pushed these tabs so many times, they don't grip quite as well, so it pulls out the tab. Even if it's clicked sort of right, it still pulls past it. Now, it's not a problem or anything. All I do is push it down a hair when I install, and it doesn't come back up. But this will also be off for quite a while as I do all my testing. And I'll put the boot and the knob back on later, maybe even tomorrow, after I'm sure everything's good. All right, a few people also had a good tip. Put down a towel before you start taking out tiny nuts on this thing. So, oh my God, I can see that they're right. I'm gonna do these two washers first. And those are going to be on the crossbars here. And there's a back crossbar. And what it is that, actually mine's pretty tight, but mine really doesn't need that. Some people's, this whole piece will shift and flex a little bit. I really can't see mine budging. I kinda don't wanna even mess with those washers in that case. Oh man, this poor dust. I mean, I watched someone else's video and theirs moved a lot more. I can't see any real movement side to side in that thing. I don't really think I have the gaps in mine. It's just not moving. It really makes no sense to me to go ahead and put those washers in. But then, you know, I don't want to have to take it apart again either. Maybe I'll just do it. I mean, it's only going to take me a couple minutes. I'm going to shove, actually this is too big. I'm going to shove a rag under these tiny little 7 millimeter nuts. You drop those, you're done for, as everybody says. I'm gonna lay a towel down there, be right back. There, now just in case I slip or just have a fumble, because you know it's getting cold out here. Here we go, it's loose. It's getting cold and my fingers get numb, and then it isn't like you drop it normally, but your fingers are icy and you just can't even feel your fingers and you just drop things. I'm gonna use two hands for this, I ain't messing around. That was definitely a pain. A couple times I dropped the nuts onto the rag, so be real careful. I do have the washers in there. A special note, they were talking about make sure you center the washers before you do your full tight. This one I did. This one, see, it's hanging down on the nut, so I have to center that one too. And I'll just, you snug them up real gentle. We're talking a tiny, tiny little wrench. And this is plastic, so be very, very gentle. Just snug them up super soft. So as I was looking at these directions, like even weeks and months back, I kept saying, how is a washer on the outside going to fix a gap on the inside? I did figure it out. It's pretty basic now that I just kind of understood what they're doing. But the only reason it would not tighten enough, and they needed this, was if there wasn't enough threads here, and this kind of bottoms out, yet it doesn't squeeze. So that's why you'd put a washer on the outside to give it a little more thread, and then it'll squeeze just enough to get that thing tight. So that has to be why they're putting a washer there, just to make sure it's extra tight and solid on there. All right, extra tight, very tight, maybe too tight, but perfect, no breakage. Just kind of really got them tight, but so that not so the plastic's gonna crack. Oh, it's real good. All right, looks like, I don't know, 10s or 12s, I can never tell these days. Those are 10s, let me go get a 10 and find out. All right, yes, they're 10s, good. Let's see, that's already up there. So I'm gonna take out the two bolts holding the 5/6 stop, just the two bolts with white. That's, I mean, everybody knows this. I'm just trying to be accurate in my own how to. Well, that's tight. Oh, whew. The paint probably like was sticky. Oh, okay, lay that down. Oh, get that out of the way. Twirl-a-rama. Get that out of the way. Twirl-a-rama. You got to use those new Allens because they got to go a lot deeper through two of these, and that's why you got to use different bolts. You wouldn't be able to fit all the new adapter in there. Now you can see, although this is attached in some way, I can't pull it out, but now it slides. That's a terrible light. Now it slides in and out, and what people usually do, they put it in fifth. Man, I don't know. I gotta see what's going on there. That's what was going on. It was already in gear, and here I was trying to shove it into gear. I couldn't tell, it was so short. So again, first, third and fourth is very tight. No movement. First is what I'm after. I'm gonna get rid of this. Remember that, let's see. Not an inch, but more than a half inch, maybe 3/4 inch. And that's what I'm gonna block. And then over here, let's see, I gotta do it with the proper hand. Fifth, right there. Okay, and then you'd kinda push this in so it's flush. And then the instructions, and most people do a tiny, tiny jiggle, tiny jiggle. Get like a half a mil gap just to make sure your gears can go in. Of course, it's too soon for that. I need to go get the other pieces. I'll get the pair in. I'll be right back. All right. I got the pair in on the other side there. Now I'm going to put the Allens in through both, the new longer Allens. God damn, that light is ridiculous. Okay. I really got to do something about that light tonight. I'll see if I got any spares. I probably do, the amount of bulbs I've had. I probably got spares. All right, this is pretty good. I don't really need a blanket under it because it's a pretty big hole you're dropping this into. Let me move this out of the way and make sure. It's pretty hard to lose your Allens here unless you're really sloppy. Oh, that's a school bus behind me. Whoa, I didn't know the school bus came right to my door. It isn't my kid, it's someone else's kid. All right, so got the screws in. Tighten them up a little bit. Then really the longest part is just sitting here adjusting it. I'm not gonna like sit here for 15 minutes with you and do that. I'm snugging them up so I can push them with my finger, but so they are not, you know, stuck. So you have a little movement. So you snug them down and then start your adjustments and feel, lock it, take it for a test, see if you can get into every gear. If you can, you're done. So this could be tricky, you know, so I'm gonna put it in first and then push this in all the way. Then you gotta do the same thing in fifth while not moving this. Keep your fingers on it. It's definitely, I can't film this. Put it in fifth and then push that one in. Then maybe do a tiny, tiny wiggle and cinch down my two bolts, yeah. Dang, guys. You guys are gonna trip out on this. Okay, I got it. I got it set up. Let me show you what we got going. So, third and fourth was always tight. Wait, clutch in, there we go. Let me get the better light there. Or third and fourth, yeah. Now let's look at first. Nothing. Second, nothing. It definitely moved. It feels like at least a quarter inch more before. That's over and up, up. I'm abusing my car. No thought whatsoever. Not even trying. And then let's look at fifth. Fifth and sixth was a lot more tricky. It seems like I got the perfect pair inside a few times, and I had a little sticky sixth gear, so I had to keep adjusting this stock one. Shell, it might not even be straight. Yeah, it does look straight. But the stock one, I wish that you had a pair and design on the stock side too, actually. But anyway, you go to fifth, goes up nice, same thing. More solid, not the first and second is most notorious. You don't get quite the dramatic effect on fifth and sixth, but it's definitely tighter. Right down to sixth. It's actually kind of a trip. Look at this. I got the big old snap-on light. You've seen it in my videos. Use it for just special occasions like this, but see, you get a glare, so you gotta be at just the right angle. You gotta have a backlight in order to get really good shots like that. So, man, that's tight. It's like a robot. First, second is my favorite. First and second is my favorite. You do gotta go over. You can't, of course, but I mean, I can't really say there's anything wrong with that. It's pretty freaking smooth. As long as I'm not being sloppy, it's perfect. You know, if I'm sloppy, I could get a little glitch. I guess maybe I'll drive it, I don't know, see if I should put all that back together and find out I need a little adjustment tomorrow or something. I kind of hate leaving it bare, but I suppose it'll be all right just for one day. Or I might even take it out tonight for maybe a few minutes, go to the store or something. And I just want to test it real time once before I buckle it all up, because I don't want to have to take this all apart again. So it's a pretty sweet mod. I already love it. I mean, everybody says, a lot of people say it's one of their favorite mods of all time. So I kind of see why now. I didn't know mine was as loose as I said previously, but that is so, so solid now. I'm actually looking forward to driving it. So I'll see you guys later. Well, that's good. I can put it in reverse. That's the first good news. It's tight in here. I got like 2 inches on each side of the mirror when I back out. But then the nice, it's kind of, it's the opposite. I got a killer driveway though. My driveway could barely fit the length of our cars before. I know you can't see me, just listen. But now I could fit car, oh, car coming. I could fit cars. Whoa, this thing just tripped me out. I was like, what's wrong with my shifter? I forgot. I was all, why is it so short? I can't even move it to the side. Okay. I'll turn these lights off so I can see properly. Damn it, now I forgot what I was... Oh, I can fit two cars length to length in the driveway now on both sides. So I can still fit four cars in my driveway now. It's just in a different fashion where now they're in... Whoa, I didn't think I was in second. I'm tripping out. This is too... Hope, you know, I'll get used to it. You know, I'll give you a little light, I guess. I'll get used to it in a couple days, but it doesn't feel right. It's too short. Dang, it's cool. It's gonna be hard to get used to tomorrow and stuff. Every time I put it in second, I feel like it didn't work. Let's see, I'm just grabbing some milk. I just needed an excuse to go out and test this. I don't want to just waste gas for nothing. And since we're almost out of milk, let me throw it in first. Dang, that's short. Oh, yeah. That feels good, except this knob really sucks, this stock knob. It's so spindly and puny. It just feels like a toy. It feels like plastic junk. I need my 100 and whatever race engine knob back. There's a reason those knobs are expensive. They're solid. This feels like plastic. Well, I'm not gonna just sit here and babble on about nothing. The shifter works good so far. So you've probably seen the video right now that you're watching, my install video, because that's how you're seeing this. So I'll see you guys later. This is another keeper. I didn't find any flaws in it. No fitment problems. You know, it's just, there's nothing to even worry about. So this is definitely another keeper mod. I'll be used to it in a couple days, and then I'll just kind of love it, you know? All right, guys, see you later. All right, I'm back for my test drive. Let me do a final tightening. Just another inch on each one, even though they're already final tightened. Okay. Now I'll show you, let's get the angle right. I'll show you my play with everything tight and where it ended up. So let's go to fifth, right there. And I need to show you close up. And you can see, I do have, right there, perfect. Absolutely perfect. 1 millimeter, possibly. It isn't pressed tight. When it's in fifth, I'm not touching it. I can go over to the right, watch this. So you have that little bit of play right there. Then we go to sixth, is a little trickier, but it's definitely not touching, it's not too tight. And again, sixth actually has more free play than fifth, a little more room. So you can see sixth here, maybe. And sixth down here, let's get the really good light going. Sixth there also has 1 mil gap. That's all you want. I mean, you want it touching, but not forcing. So this is, it could not be better. It's incredible. Perfect. 1 mil gap front and back. And of course, the fronts is even crazier, the first and second. Let's see, I mean, I just been thinking it's broke, though my whole drive out here, it's so short. First, that's first. I really have nothing. I don't have a millimeter on first, but there's zero problem getting it in first and second. Why change it? Some people may not even get it this tight, but I don't think I even have a millimeter on first, and that's fine with me. I tested it, it shifts like a dream. Let's go to second, final test. Second here, try and get you a good angle. I might have, see, it's hard to see under that, under all that pieces of hardware. So maybe I do have, but it's less on this side than it is on five and six, and it's still perfect. And I did a final tight with my longer ratchet. Absolute final, so I'm going to reassemble everything. I definitely love this mod, just like everybody else. Nothing else to really say. especially for, damn, this thing was cheap. What was it, $20 or $40? I can't remember. I found this one on Amazon. Yeah, I got it on Amazon, 2-day free shipping. I'll put a link right down there. But, I mean, most of you already have this. It's most people's first mod. And one final look, I swear, I promise. Just at where I ended up, so everybody can reference what their stuff looks like as far as the holes and stuff and the slots. And you can judge if you got about the same adjustment. I'm not centered in those. Of course, every car is different. I'm not centered. There's a little more gap on the outside of that, Alan, than the inside. But, you know, that's just dumb. Everybody's going to have an exact measurement for their own personal car and just the way it was assembled at the factory. All right, pair and shift stop. It's awesome. I actually like it probably as much as my intercooler. Imagine that. All right, guys, see you later. All right, guys, the video isn't over yet. I decided to be honest with you guys. Nothing about that. That's fine. Had a little glitch after that. I was putting my race engine knob back on, right? You know, you got the two pieces for your knob. A set screw, you use two wrenches, you torque them together, and all that, right? You see, you got a good view. Now it's a little dark. I gotta go the other way. Need the light behind us. Okay, so I just screwed these on hand tight, and the other one that's in here, hand tight. I tightened the knob, you know, should have taken a couple minutes, and I've been working on this for 2 hours. Most of that going to 3 auto parts stores looking for a long 12 by 1.25 bolt to get this thing out. Long story short, always wrench these together every time you test fit, or your top one will get stuck in there. I was almost out of hope. I had just shoved all kinds of things in there just to try and grab it. It was so tight. And I did fix it. And who knows if it's even going to screw on now. We'll find out. I can do a thread fix if I need to. But how did I fix it? Let me show you. Just if any of you ever run into that. So I just couldn't get enough grip on it. So I finally decided, let me bang a couple little notches in it. So I held it very still, and this is soft in there, and I just tapped it with the hammer, right? Like that. Then I aimed right to the other side, because this is too thin. I aimed to the other side and did as close a match as I could. Then I took my bigger wedge, which just happened to be the perfect size, and I finally was able to get this broken loose. I haven't even taken it out yet. I just wanted to show you the technique and just the idea on how I got it out. And now I'll have to see if my threads are bunged up. I've been messing with this so long. It wouldn't be the knob itself, if anything. It would just be the set screws. But, I mean, they're coming out. I'm going to make sure it screws onto my knob still. Definitely tighten it with two wrenches before I do anything. And I won't make this mistake again. But you can kind of hammer some notches into something, and you could have even kind of put something here, you know, like when you're trying to get a nut or a bolt out and you hammer a slot in it, then you sit there like that and tap it around. Same kind of idea like that, right? So I just wanted to let you know about my big headache tonight that I wasn't even going to tell you, but I said, what the hell? Because I fixed it, I decided to tell you. If I hadn't fixed it, I'd be super depressed and I just wouldn't even post about it. So I'm still getting this out. It's turning now. It was stuck so tight in there. I was hella worried that my $175 knob, whatever it was, $125, I don't know, maybe I'm exaggerating. I can't even remember. It was an expensive damn knob, that's what I'm saying. And I was worried that it was ruined. I even took heat to it, like a flame, try and get it in that. It was all just not gonna work. Hopefully it's all right. I can get it back and just be back to normal and enjoy my pair and shift stop, because this was a long night. All right, I got it out. I do think it's okay. I don't think I impeded the threads at all with those two little notches that I cut. And I just got lucky this time. I mean, this kit is probably only $10 for a new nut set, but I was worried for a while that this was what I was gonna lose. All right, guys, I'm gonna put it back together now off camera. See you later.